important topic. Okay, what is axilla? It is armpit. Okay, armpit. Other name of axilla is armpit. It contains very important structures like axillary artery, axillary vein, axillary lymph nodes. So one of the important topic of that is the axillary lymph node. So today in detail you will study the axillary lymph node. This is the two diagrams of a patient suffering from enlargement of axillary lymph node. Okay, in this you can see, what is this reason? This reason is armpit of the axilla, and in this you can see the patient has got enlargement of axillary lymph nodes. So by end of the class you will understand the reasons why it is enlarged and how you are going to distinguish it. But before that you should know the anatomy of axillary lymph node. Okay. Now the specific learning objective of my class will be, it is just a small class, at the end of the class you should be able to answer why pain occurs on the medial aspect of the arm. Why pain occurs on the medial aspect of the arm as the axillary group of lymph nodes are involved. What is the reason? So by the end of the class you will be able to answer this. The second is, you should know the subgroups of axillary lymph node. Axillary lymph node is again divided into different groups. So by the end of the class you should answer the subgroups of axillary lymph nodes and also the level of axillary lymph node. In cancer what happens, we divide the axillary lymph nodes into level 1, level 2 and level 3. So you should know which level of axillary lymph nodes is affected in breast cancers. The axillary lymph nodes will be covered under introduction, the subgroups of axillary lymph nodes and applied anatomy. Generally for any class, for example I have completed two of the bone also, at the end of the class I give you some applied aspect or clinical aspect related to the topic. So here also just 1 or 2 minutes we will give for the applied anatomy. Now this is the diagram which is taken from Cunningham's. Okay, Cunningham's is a very good book for the dissection part. Okay, so this is exactly what we see when the dissection is done. As you remember, what is this? This is pectoralis major muscle. Pectoralis major muscle lies over chest. Yes, thoracic region over the chest. So to go inside, firstly you have to dissect the pectoralis major muscle, and thereafter you can see this is the pectoralis major muscle. Just below here lies the pectoralis minor muscle, and this circular thing is all the lymph nodes. These are all lymph nodes. So exactly when you will dissect the body in Cunningham's and Grant's anatomy, exactly what we see after the dissection, that is the real diagram. So you can see here different group of axillary lymph nodes after removing pectoralis major and minor muscle. You can see the subclavian group, the lateral group, the pectoral group. All these groups you can see. Okay, the introduction is that the axillary lymph node is lying in the axilla and it is embedded in the fibrofatty tissues. In the axilla, what is there? Fibrofatty tissues are there inside that axillary lymph node lies, and the usually the number varies from 20 to 30. What is the total number of axillary lymph nodes? 20 to 30. Very good. Now, this is the diagram which is taken from Gray's anatomy. This diagram is taken from Gray's anatomy. Here you can see this is axillary vein. What is this? This is axillary vein. The lymph nodes are arranged around the axillary vein. They are arranged around the axillary veins. In green color, what are these? These are all lymph nodes which are arranged around the axillary veins. So here you can see the subscapular nodes, the humeral nodes, the pectoral and the central, and the uppermost is the apical nodes. Okay. So when you will see the Gray's anatomy book, for your level, if you see in student Gray's anatomy book, you can see the diagram is very clear as compared to the dissection diagram. So you will better understand. This is the axillary vein, and around here so many lymph nodes are arranged. Another diagram is, this is the line diagram. For better understanding, this is the line diagram. So firstly you write down the subgroups of axillary lymph node. Write down the subgroups of axillary lymph node. The subgroups of axillary lymph nodes are following. The subgroups of axillary lymph nodes are following. First, anterior axillary nodes. Anterior axillary nodes. First is the anterior axillary node. Second is the posterior axillary node. Posterior axillary node. Third is the lateral axillary node. Fourth is the central axillary node. apical axillary nodes. So I repeat once more. First is the anterior axillary node. Second is the posterior axillary node. Third is the lateral axillary node. Fourth is central axillary node. And fifth is the apical axillary lymph node. So just just one or two lines about the each group. First, what you have written? Anterior axillary lymph node. Anterior axillary lymph node. Write down. Anterior axillary lymph node is arranged around lateral thoracic vein. You can see this is which nodes? Anterior axillary lymph node. This is the axillary vein, one of its tributary. One of the tributary of axillary vein is called lateral thoracic vein. And the anterior axillary lymph nodes are arranged around which vein? Lateral thoracic vein. Which muscle is this? Pectoralis minor. So to locate the anterior axillary lymph node, you can say it is located below the pectoralis minor muscle around lateral thoracic vein. Just one line about the anterior axillary nodes. It is situated or located below pectoralis minor muscle. It is situated or located below pectoralis minor muscle around the lateral thoracic vein. The posterior, second is the posterior axillary nodes. The posterior axillary nodes are arranged around subscapular vein. Third one is the lateral axillary lymph nodes. The lateral axillary nodes are arranged around axillary vein in relation to the humerus. You can see here which bone is this? Humerus. This is the axillary vein and this is the lateral axillary nodes. Fourth is the central axillary node. This is what? Central axillary node. Now the central axillary nodes, when involved in case of cancer, right now, central axillary nodes, when involved in case of breast cancer, the patient complains severe pain along medial aspect of arm. The reason I will tell you after one or two slides, okay? It is because of the involvement of one nerve, okay? Now the apical group is lying just below the clavicle. This is the apical group. It is lying just below the clavicle bone. Which bone is this? Clavicle. It is lying just below the clavicle bone, and all the lymphatics, the previous, all lateral, anterior, posterior, all the lymphatics ultimately drain into apical group of lymph nodes. Write down the fifth one. Apical group of lymph nodes are located just below the clavicle, and lymphatics from all other groups ultimately drains into apical axillary nodes. rather, and from the apical axillary lymph nodes, and from the apical axillary lymph nodes, the lymphatics, and from the apical axillary nodes, the lymphatics ultimately drains into right subclavian trunk or thoracic duct. Right subclavian trunk or thoracic duct. So all the lymphatics in our body will ultimately drain either from the right side or the thoracic duct. Thoracic duct is the major lymphatic channel which will take all the lymphatics of the body. And in the right hand part there is right subclavian trunk which the lymphatics drainage is about smaller groups, 1/4 part. 3/4 part is into the thoracic duct. Now this is the axillary lymph nodes in terms of level. Now here this muscle is pectoralis minor muscle. Pectoralis major and pectoralis minor muscle, both are the muscles of chest, but the outermost muscle is pectoralis major muscle. When we will dissect out the pectoralis major muscle, below you will find as pectoralis minor muscle. Now in that reason, pectoralis minor muscle is also called as the key muscle. Why it is called as the key muscle? Because axillary artery lymph nodes are all divided into level because of correlation with the pectoralis minor muscle. So here the lymph node which is lying just below the pectoralis minor muscle, which muscle is this? Pectoralis minor muscle. And the lymph nodes which are lying just below pectoralis minor muscle is called level 1.